Namaste, I'm Mini and welcome to my channel Food Atomic. Today we are going to see the recipe for cream of broccoli soup. And if you are a new viewer, please click on the subscribe button. So let's get started. These are the list of ingredients we would need for preparing the cream of broccoli soup. I have also listed them in the description section. Heat a pan. I'm using a big deep pan. Add 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. Now add one finely chopped medium onion. Stir the onion and let it cook for 5 to 7 minutes over medium heat. Once you see the onion has become golden brown or turned soft, go ahead and add 4 to 5 chopped garlic cloves. Let this cook over 2 to 3 minutes over medium heat. Once the raw smell of garlic disappears after 2 to 3 minutes, add 500 ml of water to the pan. Then add 1/2 tablespoon of salt and 1 teaspoon of black pepper powder. Give it a mix and then cover it and let it cook for about 15 to 20 minutes or till you see the mixture boiling. You can cook this over low or medium heat. Once you see the water starts to boil, take off the cover. Now we are going to add the vegetables to this mix. So add one roughly chopped medium-sized potato. Then add around 200 grams of cauliflower florets and one medium-sized chopped broccoli. We need to make sure that the vegetables are covered with water, and if required, you can add a little bit more water as well. Now we are going to cover it again and let it cook till all the vegetables are completely cooked. This might take around another 10 to 15 more minutes. After 15 minutes, you can check by breaking the vegetables with the help of a spoon. At this point, switch off the heat and let it cool down and then blend everything together. This is how the mixture looks after blending. These are the list of ingredients we would need to prepare the cashew cream. So to the blender, add 100 grams of soaked cashews, 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast, 50 ml of soy milk or any other plant-based milk, and then juice of 1/2 a lemon. Blend everything together and we will get the cashew cream. Heat a pan and add the vegetable paste we prepared earlier. Then add 2 teaspoons of salt or salt as per taste. Add 2 teaspoons of cumin powder. Give everything a mix. If you like, you can always add other seasonings of your choice. Now we'll add the cashew cream to this. I have written cashew cream as optional because the cauliflower and potato brings good richness to this broccoli soup. But I still like to add the cashew cream to bring out further creaminess to this recipe. Now let this cook over low heat, and when you start to see the boil, go ahead and add 1 to 2 teaspoons of black pepper powder and switch off the heat. Give everything a mix and the cream of broccoli soup is ready. Now I'll go ahead and show you how you can garnish it and serve it for your guests or family members. So this quantity should be good enough for 6 people. Go ahead and pour it in a soup bowl. This is one of my favorite recipe which I like to meal prep from time to time, as it's so simple to prepare and it can easily last in the fridge for a longer time. And I've also listed the ingredients I'll be using for seasoning. You can always add or reduce the ingredients as per your choice. So I'm starting with some leftover cashew cream. So again guys, you can always prepare this recipe without the cashew cream and it will be still very rich and good. And just for the look of it, I'm adding some broccoli. Now I'm adding some pumpkin seeds, followed by some sunflower seeds, adding some toasted sesame seeds, and finally topping it up with some freshly ground black pepper powder. If you want it to be more spicy, you can always add some chili flakes. So there we go, guys. This easy, healthy, and delicious cream of broccoli soup is ready, which can be prepared in a jiffy. I have also listed some of the benefits of eating broccoli. Make sure to check them out too. So guys, if you enjoyed this recipe, please let me know your feedback in the comment section. And also, if you would consider making this recipe for yourself or for your family members. So that's all for today. I will see you soon with another interesting vegan recipe. Until then, bye.